Hi, my name is Vanessa Ho, an acupuncturist here at Healing with Zen in Pasadena. Today we'll be talking about facial mapping and how that pertains to how acupuncturists and herbalists treat you as a patient, whether you have skin conditions that you're coming in for, or whether we're looking towards your face to see what else is going on inside and how we can balance that out. So the first thing that I want to go ahead and cover in terms of facial mapping is that every single area on your face correlates to a certain organ and an organ's function in the Chinese medicine realm. It's through facial mapping that we're able to treat different illnesses using some points on the face, whether that illness is actually directly on the face or not. For example, we could be treating some digestive issues by using some facial acupuncture points that are on the forehead or around the sides of the mouth, both areas of which really help with digestion. So, in this way, we're able to really look at the face first without the patient even letting us know their symptoms just yet, and we are already starting to formulate our treatment plan to see what area has more problems, and so what are the organs that are in imbalance that we can balance out for you. So, in terms of any conditions that you have on the skin, such as acne, discoloration, or hyperpigmentation, any textural changes or red flushing, anything like that, if there's a certain area on your face that these issues keep coming up over and over again, and it's the same area, it's more likely than not that you're dealing with an internal imbalance that really corresponds with one certain organ or one certain function. And the way that we can really figure out what that is by facial mapping. So let's go ahead and start and look at what each area is in terms of its correspondence to organs and functions, as well as dysfunctions. So let's go ahead and start at the top. So right on that forehead area, it correlates to the small intestine as well as the nervous system. That's a big reason why earlier when I was talking about if you had any digestive issues, that the forehead is going to be one of the first areas that you'll see different acne scarring, acne marks, or any discolorations in. For example, if it's a little more red in that area, or if you just keep getting those pesky acne coming back up in that area, usually it's going to be with the small intestine and the nervous system in balance. And what that means is that there's that portion of your digestion that's very important in order for us to excrete out toxins that's just not functioning that well. And in that way, you're keeping some of those toxins internally, and that's where they eventually show up. That's where they try to get out of the body, is going to be through that area, and then you'll get those pimples, you'll get that redness, perhaps a rash. And what we want to do to really avoid that is have a better diet. And moving on down, the area in between our eyebrows denotes the liver. And in Chinese medicine, the liver really is correlated to stress and even more so anger. So a lot of times if that organ is imbalanced, you're going to see that you have some really deep set lines or ridges in between the eyebrows, or maybe that area just seems to always be red, which is a color for anger. And or you could also have recurrent acne in that area, and that would really denote a lot of built up stress or buildup of toxins, both of which are correlated because when your body is stressed, that circulation is not going as smoothly as it really should be, and again, it leads up to buildup of toxins, especially in the liver, because that organ is really definitely affected by stress, stressful situations, anything like that. So for the area under the eyebrows as well as under the eyes, that area is related to the kidney as well as the urinary bladder and the adrenal system. What that means is that the kidney in Chinese medicine is an organ that is related to water. And if you're not having enough hydration, if your body's dehydrated, it's going to show up on these areas. You're going to have drier skin, you're going to have darker areas under the eyes, and it's really important to keep hydrated because it's going to show when your kidney is stressed. And in terms of that, you're also going to have to make sure that your eyebrows are actually darker than the hair that's on your head. Usually that is the case, and if the eyebrow hairs are actually lighter than the hair that's on your head, then that also denotes that there's a weak kidney in action. And when we talk about the kidney or any organ in Chinese medicine, it isn't specifically the organ itself and that organ's function. And in other words, I'm not saying that there's any kidney failure going on. I'm just saying that the function of the kidney definitely needs to be improved. If that area, which is under your eyes or under your eyebrows, is showing signs of problems and showing these recurrently. So that's it for today's video, the first part of the facial mapping series that we're doing. And make sure that you tune in to the next video where we'll cover the rest of the parts of the face. And also make sure that you hop on over to our website at healingwithzen.com and click on that blog post tab that you're going to see on the front page, because we have so much more information for you in terms of how you can help at home if you have certain problem areas that we talked about today. All right, we'll see you in the next one.